Today, I am going to tell the story of the Cinderella. Once upon a time, there used to be a man who is very wealthy and he has a big palace. He has one daughter and one wife. On one day, the wife was very ill and her conditions were so critical that she might even die. She was alone crying on the bed and the husband would not let anyone near her except her little and lovely daughter Cinderella. When Cinderella approached her mother, her mother told that, "Oh my darling, don't cry, I will not die, and even if I die, the God will always take care of you, and even I will look and take care of you from the heaven." And those were the last words of the wife, and after that she died. And then after her death, Cinderella have cried for so long. Some days have passed, and her father actually thought that someone needs to take care of Cinderella, and I can't take care of her because I need to go for work very frequently. So she married a widow who had two daughters, and the widow was very cruel. When the widow came into the house where Cinderella was living, she treated her with no respect. She always punished her and treated her two daughters with the utmost courtesy, but did not even give respect to Cinderella. She was very cruel to her. Cinderella has to do every work in the home, including the things like cleaning the home, washing the dishes, repairing the stuff in the home and everything. Cinderella was very sad because of that. She used to cry very frequently. On one day, when Cinderella was cleaning the floor, the two sisters were sitting on a sofa and eating the fruits. They were so greedily eating while Cinderella was hardworking and cleaning the floor. So when Cinderella was cleaning the floor, one of the sisters threw a banana peel on the floor, and the stepmother was just arriving into the floor onto the place where Cinderella was cleaning. And she saw the banana peel, and she saw the banana peel, which made the floor very untidy. She got very angry and shouted Cinderella. Cinderella again felt very sad, but she was a kind-hearted person, so she said that even if she had no mistake, "Sorry, my mother, I will clean it." And she continued her cleaning. And on one day, she was not even allowed to eat. Her stepmother told that you should only eat the leftovers from our food. And from that point, Cinderella was very sad, and she knew that anything good won't happen to her. Days passed and passed. On one day, it was the birthday of a beautiful prince, and the father of that prince was a king. So the king conducted a big party and told all the maidens in the and gave an announcement to all the young maidens in the country to gather in the king's ballroom so that his son could pick up the woman who he loves. So every young woman was so excited for that, including the two sisters of Cinderella. And Cinderella herself. Cinderella was very excited to go to the ballroom as she has never seen the palace before. So she is waiting for the day very eagerly. And when the day came, the stepmother readied her two daughters and make the arrangements and required preparations to take the two daughters to the ballroom. But she did not tell Cinderella to go there. And Cinderella was very sad as she wanted to see the palace and the ballroom so badly. And she again felt sad. Two of the sisters had left the house and only Cinderella was left in the house. Then she thought to escape from the house and go to the ballroom. But to go to the ballroom, she needs a dress, right? She needs a nice dress. So she looked at her mother's wardrobe and saw a dress which is very untidy and also torn. So she was trying to fix the dress with the help of some mouse who became her friends since a long time. While she was stitching the dress, she knew that it will take so much time and the party will be completed before she could stitch the dress. And from that point, she was heartbroken. And after some time, a magical air god fairy appeared, who Cinderella called as a godmother. And that godmother gave Cinderella a new beautiful dress for the ballroom. She also gave her a new pair of shoes, and those shoes were made up of glass and they were very shiny. So Cinderella quickly rushed for the ballroom. When she saw the prince, she fell in love with him. And even the prince fell in love with Cinderella at the first sight. They both of them danced together for so much time that Cinderella forgot a statement which the godmother had told. The godmother told that you will be like this only for the midnight. After the midnight, you'll be turned back to normal. Cinderella forgot to see the time, and it was just 5 minutes in which midnight will be crossed. So she was very tensed and ran away from the prince. While she was running away, she left one of her glass shoes in the ballroom. But she has rushed without collecting it, as there was no time for midnight. And she rushed away to her home before midnight has happened. And in the way she lost her qualities and turned back to normal. Anyway, she finally managed to reach the home. And the next day, the prince came with all the prince told the king that I will find that girl even if I have to search the whole country because I love her. The prince was actually trying to find her with the help of the shoe. So the king and the soldiers were searching every home to find a woman to whom the shoe can fit. So if the shoe fits to a woman, that's Cinderella. And that's how the prince will recognize her. They were searching every home and they reached the home of the cruel stepmother. The stepmother wantonly locked Cinderella in the attic so that she could not be recognized by the soldiers. The soldiers came by and the two daughters of the stepmother have tried the shoe. Both of them, the shoe did not fit to both of them. So when they were about to leave, the soldiers found Cinderella in the attic. She found her and the shoe was perfect to her. And the prince recognized Cinderella at that point and proposed as soon as he met her. He asked her whether she will marry her or not. She said, "Of course I'll marry you," and both of them left and led a happy life. Thank you.